So dear students, in our last section we have seen data, data items, data objects. In this section we will see data structure, the types of data structure, the operations, pointer, structure and the memory management. So what is data structure? Data structure is a way of organizing all the data types that considers not only elements stored but also their relationship to each other. In our last section we have seen data type. So data structure is a way of organizing all the data types which considers not only the element that is stored but also the relationship with each other. So suppose we are having set of domains D, functions M and axioms A. So the triplet, that is DFA, which is considerably domain, function and axioms, denotes the data structure D. Domain means data type that used to describe the particular structure, that is nothing but domain, which is nothing but D. F is nothing but function, which is responsible for the operation that will be performed on the structure, and A is nothing but the axiom, which describes the semantics or rules of the operation. For example, suppose we are having D, that is nothing but integer, then the domain is integer or boolean. Functions are 0, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and axioms are 0 returns true if x is 0 and then according to the operation. That is nothing but the data structure, which is combination of DFA triplet. Now the abstract data type. It is useful tool for specifying the logical properties of a data type. ADT refers to the mathematical concept that defines the data type. Even though ADT is not concerned with implementation, but it is useful in making use of data type correctly. Abstract data type is not related to the implementation part, but it is useful in making use of data type in a correct way. Now we have seen what is data structure. It is nothing but triplet of DFA. So we can refer ADT as a triple. Only condition is that axioms include the detailed representation of the function. We will see in stack and queue in detail what will be the abstract data structure for stack, what will be it for queue. So when we are talking about the ADT of a triplet, then axioms should include the detailed representation of function that we are going to perform on our particular data. Now there are types of data structures, that is primitive data structure and non-primitive data structure. So the primitive data structures are the operated on data by machine instructions and can be used to build other non-primitive data types like integer, float, character, pointer. These are the primitive data structures. And non-primitive data structures are defined from primitive data types, means whatever primitive data types we are having, that is integer, float, character, pointer. From that particular primitive data structures, the data structures are defined, that are called as the non-primitive data structure, like array, list, file, tree, graph. So now what is structure? So structure is used to define the data type which allows to combine data of different types together. By using structure, we can combine the different data types in single way. In structure, data is stored in the form of records. Structure is a group or variable of different data types which is represented by the single name, that is called as structure. And what is pointer? Pointer is a variable which is used to store memory address of that particular variable. Now it stores the value and pointer address the variable where the values are stored or connected. So for accessing the memory address and the data, we can use the pointer. Now the structures are there. So what is the first? That is array. That is the non-primitive data structure. So what is array? Array is collection of elements of similar type. And it will be collection, but how? It collects the similar types which stored on the consecutive memory locations. They can be one, two, multi-dimension according to the need. Now suppose this is particular example. The array is there and this array is of the integer elements. Now the next part is linked list. So what is linked list? It is collection of data items. Each element is having node and each node contains two fields. That two fields are one for data and one for storing the address of next node, that is pointer. That's why we have studied what is pointer. Pointer is pointing the next memory address. So linked list is a collection of data items where the node contains the first field, that is data, and the second field contains the memory pointer to the next memory address where the next data is stored. Next is stack. So stack is what? Stack is collection of elements in which insertion and deletion can be done by only one end, that is called as top. It works in the LIFO structure, that is last in first out, where we can insert the element from top and we can delete the element from top. That we will see in our next section in detail. Queue is also collection of elements, but the difference is that insertion is done from one end, which is called as rear, and deletion is done from the another end, which is called as front. Queue works in the FIFO structure, that is first in first out. That also we will see in detail in our next section. Next is tree. Tree is a finite set of nodes in which one is the special node, that is called as root node, and the another are the parent and child nodes, where each and every node is having particular degree and the tree is having level and height. Now the next part is graph. Graph is nothing but collection of edges and vertices, where the graph is represented by connecting the edges and vertices to each other. Now the operations, these were the various data structures. Now which are the operations that are used on that particular data structure are traversing, searching, inserting, deleting, sorting and merging. Traversing means we will visit each and every record, that is nothing but traversing. Searching means finding any particular record by the given key value is searching. Inserting is adding a new record into the structure. Deleting is removing the record from the structure. Sorting is arranging the records in some particular order. Merging is combining the records in a single record, that is nothing but merging. So these are the six operations that are performed on the data structure. Now the static and dynamic memory management. So in static memory management, variables get allocated permanently and the allocation is done before the execution of program. In static memory, the allocation is done when we will start the program execution. Before that, the allocation is done. And in dynamic memory, in dynamic memory management, the variable is allocated only if program unit gets active. So in this, allocation is done during program execution. It uses the data structure whenever the dynamic allocation is used. There is memory reusability because of dynamic memory allocation. So this is nothing about the static and dynamic memory management. So in this section, we have seen the data structure, the operations on that data structures, and the static dynamic memory management. Thank you.